So third generation 3G mobile communication system are showing their strength around the world. And 3G system can provide a global mobility with a wide range of service including tele services and bearer services. Tele services include speech and short message services, whereas bearer services enable information transfer between access points. Characteristics of bearer services can be negotiated at a connection or session establishment. Typical example of bearer services include video telephony, video on demand, multimedia, movie and internet applications such as a web browsing and web casts. UMTS, what is UMTS now? UMTS stands for Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. It supports multiple services and multiple quality of services at data rate up to 2 Mbps for packet switch data and 384 kbps for circuit switch data without high speed downlink packet access HSTPA. And with HSTPA, the data rate could be 10 Mbps. UMTS provide high voice quality, improved spectral efficiency and high system capacity. The high voice quality can be attributed to the usage of the adaptive multi-rate voice coder, which provide an improvement over the enhancement full rate vCoder used in global system for mobile communication system. The improvement in system capacity is achieved through fast power control. Power control in UMTS run at 1500 Hz on both uplink and downlink as opposed to 2 Hz in GSM system. UMTS system is divided in three parts. Core network, access network, and user equipment. It is divided in three parts: core network, access network, and user equipment. Core network consists of circuit switch core network and packet switch core network. Circuit switch core network and packet switch core network. User equipment is mobile or data terminal. Access network is a UMTS terrestrial radio access network. Universal Terrestrial Radio Access Network. It's called UTRAN, which may operate in frequency division duplex and time division duplex. It's operate in FDD and TDD. UTRAN FDD access network uses wideband co-division multiplexes. It uses wideband co-division multiple axis. It's called WCDMA protocol and operate at 3.84 megachip per second. And TDD and UTRAN TDD access network may operate either 3.84 megachip per second or 1.28 megachip per second. and is a conventionally called WCDMA access network. Utron TDD access network may operate either at 3.84 megachip per second or 1.28 megachip per second. The radio access operating at 1.28 megachip per second is also called low chip rate TDD. Now we will know the evolution of WCDMA. UMTS is deployed under the GSM or Global Packet Radio Services. In the GSM map core network family, GSM system provide voice and basic data services, while GPRS enhanced data rate for GSM evolution. So when see the evolution of WCDMA, GSM, GPRS, Edge and WCDMA. GPRS enhanced data rate for GSM. GSM mainly actually service provide voice and basic data services. Basic data services it provide. GPRS enhance the data rate of GSM evolution. From evolution standpoint, next step is WCDMA, which uses the GSM map core network architecture but with a different access network. Since WCDMA is evolved from GSM, the higher layer of the two systems are essentially the same. These include mobility management, GPRS mobility management, connection management and session management. Mobility management and connection management are in circuits domain, while GPRS mobility management and session management are in packet switch domain. In connection management, there are call control services, short message services, supplementary services. In addition to the higher layer being the same, WCDMA share another similarity with GSM. The universal subscriber identity module for UMTS is based on subscriber identity module for GSM. Now we will see the UMTS network. UMTS network include a variety of the network element with a specific function. Firstly, those network element that switch and route call and data connection to external network are called core network element. Secondly, those that handle all the radio link functions are called radio access network element. Thirdly, those that serve as a interface between humans and network are called user equipment. So this core network, access network and UE. So in core network, I have told that switched and route call and data connection to the external network. This is the core network, and Second, that is a handle the all the radio loop functions are called radio access network element. And thirdly, those that serve the interface between the humans and network are called user equipment. IU interface is defined between the core network and radio access network. UU interface defined between the radio access network and user equipment. So we will see in detail in architectures interface, all the interface I will see in detail. So now come on. Core network. Is GMAC, MSC VLR, GGSN, SGSN to Utron. This is connected to Utron. This is for the CS domain, circuits domain, and packets domain. Here, core network, external network. This is core network. Basic core network architecture for UMTS is a fundamentally based on GSM network with GPRS. The structure of the core network is showing in a structure. It consists of circuit switch domain and packet switch domain. In the circuit switch domain, the network element include mobility switching center and visitor location register, and gateway mobile switching center, MSC VLR and GMAC is in circuit switch domain. And in a packet switch domain, network element include service GPRS support node SGSN and gateway GPRS support node GGSN. Other network element such as HLR, home location register, and AUC authentication center, and shared by both domain. The circuit switch domain network element handle circuit switch traffic such as voice and low data rate, while the packet switch network element handle packet switch traffic such as multimedia. And this is the core network architectures. Now Utron architectures. Here we will see the Utron architecture. It's connected. IUR node B at node B, because multiple node B is connected to RNC. So radio access network, this is the radio access network RAN. This is a radio access network called Utron, provide a interface access for the UE. Within UTRAN, two interfaces are defined, IUB and IUR. Two interfaces are defined within UTRAN. The IUB interface consists of the node B and the RNC. Node B and RNC, this is consist of IUB interface, and IUR interface is between the two RNC. UTRAN uses the direct sequence CDMA technique, in which user data is multiplied with orthogonal variable spreading factor code. In addition, scribbling code and synchronization code are respectively employed for the scrambling and synchronization of the user data. Node B is responsible for the AR interface transmission and reception, modulation and demodulation, physical channel coding, micro diversity, error correction, closed loop power control. The RNC is respectively for radio resource control. RNC is responsible for radio resource control, admission control, channel allocation, power control setting, handover control, micro diversity, ciphering, segmentation, reassembling, broadcast signaling, open loop power control. These many functions are responsibility are involved for the RNC and node B. User equipment. This is user equipment. Third part is user equipment. User equipment is the AR interface counterpart of node B. The basic structure of the user equipment. This is the basic structure of the user equipment. Generally, it contains mobile equipment and UMTS subscriber identity module. The CU interface is introduced between ME and the USIM to provide the electrical connection. A UE has many different type of identities and functionality. The key UE identity include internationally mobile subscriber identity, MC, temporary mobile subscriber TMC, and packet temporary mobile subscriber identity PTMCI, and internationally mobile station equipment identity IMEI. These all the key are included in UE side. UE can operate in circuit switch mode, packet switch mode, or hybrid mode. When operating in circuit switch mode, the UE attaches to the circuit switch domain and offers circuit switch services only. If the UE operates in packet switch mode, it attaches to the packet switch domain and offers packet switch services only. However, some special circuit switch services such as voice over IP may also be offered over the packet switch domain. When the UE operates in hybrid mode, it attaches to both the circuit switch and packet switch domain. Both the circuit switch and packet switch services are offered simultaneously. This mode also known as CS and PS mode. Frequency band. frequency band, megahertz to 9080 megahertz for uplink, and 2110 megahertz to 2170 megahertz is for downlink. Deployment in other frequency band is not a precluded. Ultra TDD operate in 900 to 920, and TDD operate 1900 to 920 and 2010 to 2025 band. These are for the TDD channels. And channel spacing 5 megahertz. So we will discuss over the channel information in next chapters. So we see the next information about now here UMTS network topology. So we will discuss the fundamental of UMTS. The UMTS system consists of three major parts. Already have discussed the core network, access network, and user equipment. The core network contains all the switching and routing elements that are capable of connecting the circuit switch call to the public switch telephone network PSTN and the packet switch call to packet data supporting network PDSN. The core network also performs the function of mobility management, subscriber location management, and authentication. Basically, the fundamental of the core network in WCDMS system are similar to that GSM GPRS system. The difference is that new interface to UTRAN is introduced. The access network and user equipment are totally new. The access network contains all of the radio equipment that is necessary for the accessing the core network. For WCDMA, the access network is UTRAN and the GSM GPRS is a GSM GPRS radio access network. The user equipment could be mobile or. So here we have discussed the. This is the part core network, radio access network, and user equipment. So it was like that. CS domain, PS domain, UTRAN, GRAN, UE, user equipment. Core network and access network UTRAN and GRAN, access network and user equipment. User equipment CS domain is connected to PSTN public switch telephone network, and PS domain is connected to PDSN. Already have told that core network contain all of the switching and routing element that are capable of connecting the circuit switch call to public switch telephone network and the packet switch call to a packet data supporting network. So packet data supporting network and PSTN public switch telephone network. And now discuss over the UMTS signaling protocol stack. So next tutorials, next video tutorial, we will discuss over the UMTS signaling protocol stack, and we will know that all the layer information. And so thank you for watching my video too.